Hi guys, welcome back. In today's video, we will be discussing about Bazaar Style Retail Limited. It's a fairly new company, jiska IPO aaya hai recently in the month of September only. And yesterday itself, iska Q1 FY25 result aaya hai. Okay, so let us discuss about it. We will look at the business model. We will look as to like how the Q1 FY25 result have been, and you know the guidance going forward. And also we will do a P2P comparison and you know valuation ka dekhenge. Agar you know how does it lie the valuation with respect to its peers. Right, so that's that. Today we will be doing it. I will just share my screen so it makes it easier. I think, yeah, done. Okay, so the company is called as Bazaar Style Retail. Okay, so I would just want you to look at this picture. This is how the stores of Bazaar Style Retail is. And I think by just looking at the picture, you guys understand, right? This is an apparel company. You can see here, kapda sab bech raha hai. And just by looking at the locality where the store is located and everything, you understand ki like, ye jo company hai, inka jo sara stores jo hai, they sell it in the T2, T3 cities like that. Okay, now before I get into ki like, ye agar aap dekhto, basically, if you look at this Bazaar Style Retail, they go by the name as Style Bazaar. You can see this, right? Style Bazaar hai. Inka dukaan ka naam Style Bazaar hota hai. And they sell a lot of this apparel as well as non-apparel. Theek hai? Matlab apparel mein aapka ladka ka kapda, boys, men, kids, women, sare ka sara kapda you get. As well as you get this home, you know, the home furnishing items such as your blanket, towels, pillow covers, etc. Right? So there are two types of this in this business. And if you look at it over here, they are very, very prominent in the northeastern part of India and the eastern belt of India. Okay, like especially they originated in West Bengal, so they're very prominent in the West Bengal and Odisha region in that area. Okay, so now if you look as of this Q1 FY25 and the recent update that they have, you see that they have 181 stores. And if you look at their trajectory, right, if you look at the last 3 years ka unka revenue growth dekho ya pad ka growth dekho, it has been very stunning. You know, they have been growing consistently also at 30% in that rate. So overall, you can tell over the last few years, their growth rate has been very stunning. And in fact, these people compare themselves to the likes of V2 Retail and V-Mart. Okay, and unko lagta hai ki like, you know, they are the fastest growing in the eastern part of India, because in terms of store, in terms of revenue, they feel they have a lot of hold over there. They have a lot of power in terms of, you know, the locality and everything. Now coming to in terms of like the business model itself, where do these people come, like in what range, right? Because in the entire retail, or the especially in the apparel space, we see that there are many divisions, or you can tell many categories in terms of price point. Of course, you have the, you know, you have some brands such as Lifestyle, I can't, Zara, H&M, all this, which are a bit of fast fashion, a bit of a, I would say in fast fashion league, it is a bit of a premium fast fashion, you can call it, right? I'm just talking about in the fast fashion league. And then you have your Zudio, which is a, you know, aspiring to be premium kind of brand. And then you have your value products such as your Style Bazaar, V2 Retail, V-Mart, etc. So these people come in this category, not really a competitor of Zudio, but I would say a much better competitor of in terms of like V2 Retail and V-Mart. Okay, so that is what this company does. And these people, if you look at them, you know, they take a pride at pride in themselves as to like, you know, they like to cater to people who are looking, you know, for fashion, very, very fashion conscious, you know, especially these days, you know, a lot of fast fashion, you have to keep changing your clothes every now and then based on the trends. But also that the same kind of people who are very conscious, I mean, in the sense ke, like, you know, who are very conscious in terms of price point also. So they're trying to provide value plus fashion. That is what the where they lie. And also, if you look at their category, the kind of category they're targeting is whose annual income, like it is mentioned over here, you know, less than $5,000. So it roughly comes up to like, let's say, whosoever annual income is between 2 to 3 lakhs, I think in that range, you know, that is the kind of crowd, that is the kind of category that these people are targeting. Okay, now just let us just look at this section, like what part of revenue comes from where. So this is from the Q1 FY25 presentation. Like I told you, right, inka do segment hai. One is the apparel segment and the other one is the general merchandise. Apparel segment mein aapko aata hai men, women, as well as kids, right? And in this men, women and kids, you can see here in the apparel space, this is contributing 86.8%. Last year in the same quarter, it was 83.9% and now it is 86.8%. Similarly, if you look at the general merchandise, merchandise, its share, the share of pie over here is completely is reducing. You can tell it's 16.1% tha, abhi 13.2. So as of Q1 FY25, majority of the revenue you can tell is coming from the apparel space, which is 86% is coming from there. Now in this part, in this the apparel space, kis mein zyada ho rahe? You can see here again, men is more that they cater to. Almost 43% are men se out of this, and 29% are women se, and similar portion is coming from kids. So they're much more into, you know, like selling a lot of men clothes than women or kids. Okay. Now comes as to like, agar ye style bazaar mein aap jaate ho, inka store mein jaate ho, apna khud ka brand ho, do they sell their own brands? Are they making their own clothes, manufacturing it and selling it? Or are they selling a third party brands? Because if you sell a third party brands, of course, aapka margins thoda kam hi hoga. Now, yahan par bhi, if you see, inka agar aap dekhte ho, yahan pe you can you see private labels, right? Private label means the, you know, un sab ka, you know, style bazaar itself is designing it. They're making the clothes and they're selling it. Matlab, it is their own brand. They're not selling somebody third party ka brand apne store mein bech nahi raha. Like if you look at Zudio only sells their clothes. They are not selling other people ka clothes. If you look at V2 Retail also sells 80% khud ka hi brand hai, and they have multiple brands and they sell it in their stores, right? Similarly over here, can you see here from FY22 to FY24, this is as of March FY24, aap dekh sakte ho yahan pe, the share of the private brand has increased, right? 25 to 31 to 38. And right now, this is FY24, that is last quarter. As of Q1 FY25, you will see 52% is coming from khud ka brand se, okay? And these are the various brands that they have, sub brands. Like, agar aapka ladkiyon ka clothes hota hai, toh they sell it under this brand. Agar chota bachcha ka clothing hota hai, then they sell it under dozo ka brand, like that. And very good, right? Because jitna aapka hi khud ka brand hoga, aapka zyada bargaining power hoga yahan pe. So over here also, again, one more very positive thing that we are seeing is the private brand ko portion that is there has been increasing. Okay, now if you look, as I told you, right, these people have a very strong hold in terms of West Bengal and Odisha. That is the primary market. These people originated from West Bengal, and now they're getting very strong foothold in West Bengal and Odisha, and targeting the nearby states such as Tripura, Uttar Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, you know, jo bhi uska heart belt mein hai, like, you know, in the belts of that area, that is what they're targeting. So as of FY24, you can see here the store count also, they have totally 162 stores. This is as of Q4 FY24. Like I told you, Abhinka 181 stores. Can you see here? I think, 181 stores. This is as of yesterday. Because yesterday in ek update aaya tha, they had opened another one store in West Bengal. And as if you add that store, total store count has gone to 181. This is as per the Q1 FY25 ka presentation se, you know, uske baad bhi, you know, a lot of store has been added, but this one is 162 stores. Agar aap dekhte ho, yahan par bhi you will see the core market se zyada aa rahe. That is your West Bengal and Assam. That is the most important two states. That is where the most revenue is coming from. Aap bol sakte ek geographical concentration hai bahut sara in a particular state, right? And now if you look at it over here, the other stores, so of course, right, jitna aapka store, zyada se zyada store agar ek state mein hai, the revenue contribution bhi usi state se aayega na, compared to the other. That is why you'll see a major chunk of the revenue is coming from that West Bengal, Odisha, Assam and Bihar. Now if you look at this space, right, if you look at this entire space, whether it is V2 Retail, if you look at V-Mart, and if you look at this one also, you're seeing a lot of, you know, growth over here in the value-added products. Zudio is also a very good example. So what has really been a game changer over here? Why are we seeing all of a sudden ke like value added products mein yahan pe itna kuch bhav kyun hai, right? So if you just look at the retail space now, especially the apparel space in the retail, one second, is it recording, right? Yeah, I always get scared if it's recording or not. Yeah, so if you look at the retail apparel space, the entire if you look at the graph, I think from 2000s during that time, you can see, you know, there is a trend that was forming. Okay, so earlier when we were there, when you know, I think when I was quite young probably, or when it was, you know, when my mom was there or something, none of them had like a very branded chain that they could go and shop from. You know, it was a lot of fragmented. You had aapka, you know, probably local store, aap market mein jaate the. I think if you were of even my age, where if you grew up in my time, I think you would know, right? You would go to a dukan and you would do the shopping, or you would, there would be a specific market for clothes. That is how it started. And then people wanted to get this branded, you know, clothes and get the premium feel. And then we started having malls. And I think that was a period where all this lifestyle, Shopper Stop, you know, all this, I think first it started with an EBO, exclusive brand outlet, such as Pantaloons and all. And then followed by that, we had this multi-branded outlet, such as Lifestyle and Shopper Stop, right? Where there are multiple brands in one place. And then we had the emergence of, you know, but all of this we're catering, you know, either like a bit expensive or you're going, you know, to a normal range, you know, jahan pe aap dukaan mein jaake purchase karo. In the middle, there was nothing. So that is when the emergence of max fashion and all these kind of categories started happening. And then after that, you know, there was another range where, you know, that had to cater to T2 and T3. We had some things like Max, Zara and H&M that was catering to the a bit of a semi-premium, premium up also in terms of fast fashion for T1 cities. But for T2 and T3, there was a gap in terms of premiumness, in terms of fast fashion, in terms of aspirational brand, you could tell. And that is where Zudio, V2 Retail, V-Mart and all of these brands started entering. Because like I told you, there was a huge gap, right? And here, one of the reasons why this space really worked is right now, if you see even in T2 and T3 cities, we see a lot of urbanization that happens. We see that a lot of big families get fragmented into smaller family of four, a family of two, right? Nuclearization, which tends, since you have a less expenses, you tend to like spend more. Similarly, you're seeing right now, earlier probably you had just one person working in the household, now you have gone into being a two or dual income household, right? So more spending power comes, right, as a result. And of course, we have gone totally from an unorganized chain to organized chain. Nowadays, you do not even see people going and shopping from that chota chota kirana ka dukaan, right? Jahan pe hota hai ki, like, you know, they're selling clothes, right? Nobody goes over there, in fact. And everybody would rather go to a place like Zudio or over here, where you get that feel of premiumness, right? So that is, you can tell what the tailwind is driving over here. Now, let us understand, like, I hope the business model is clear, just to wrap it up. So Style Bazaar is nothing but they're an apparel company. They sell clothes. Jinka clothes, whose target customers are those people, jiska annual income hai shayad 2 se 4 lakh pe, in that range, right? So these people sell clothes in T2, in T3 cities, and their core markets, the main market is West Bengal and Odisha. As of right now, they have 181 stores. And not just that, if you look at their business cup segments, 86% of the revenue is coming from selling clothes, that is for men, women and kids, and the rest 14 to 15% is coming by selling aapko home furnishing items such as blankets, towels and other things, right? So now let's talk about Q1 FY25. Agar aap Q1 FY25 ka result dekhte ho, you will see that the revenue that is there has been increased by 21% on a year-on-year basis. Okay, that is from this Q1, last Q1 to this Q1, you're seeing 21% ka growth. Okay, and this is quite in line, because unka agar aap dekhte ho, they're a good 30% ka growth engine. Like overall, if you've seen their performance in FY24, performance in FY23 and so forth, very good consistent 35% ka growth engine hai ye. But unfortunately, you see that the PAT, the profit after tax, because last time FY23 se FY24 agar aap dekhte ho, PAT jo hai 5 crore se 22 crore ho gaya, theek hai, 5 crore se 22 crore. So I hope you can understand kitna bada operating leverage is Style Bazaar ko mila on a year-on-year basis. Main pura saal ka baat kar rahi hu. But here you see, is quarter mein, Q1 over Q1, you see that PAT jo hai 7 crore se minus, matlab 50 lakh ka loss mein aa gaya yahan pe. Now the reason for that is because unka ek bada warehouse tha, a very big warehouse, I think in West Bengal, which caught fire. And this resulted in a loss of 10 crore. And right now, you know, they have to spend from whatever money that they have, and they're awaiting an insurance claim for that. Also, what they're doing is, now that the warehouse is already burnt and they've lost a lot of inventory and all, they're also in a process of setting up a new state-of-the-art warehouse. So first of all, you have lost from the burning, and the other hand, you also have to spend a lot of money right now to get another warehouse up and running also, so that other stores has inventory for you to function. So overall, I think just a very, very, how do I put this? I think extremely bad luck, especially you just list, and after 20, 30 days of listing, you're posting your Q1 ka result, and you know, such an incident happened. So yeah, now if you look at, as of Q1 FY25, this is the numbers. अगर आप इनका स्टोर का अगर दूसरा पैरामीटर्स आप देखते हो, पहले लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दी स्टोर काउंट. ओके, नाउ एज ऑफ Q1 FY24 इनका 140 स्टोर्स था, अभी 166 था एज ऑफ एंड ऑफ Q1 FY25. एंड ऑफ Q1 FY25 इज व्हाट आपका अप्रैल, मई एंड जून, राइट? सो दे हैव एडेड अराउंड हाउ मच, 26 स्टोर्स. नाउ ये एक थोड़ा ताजुब का बात है, 26 स्टोर्स, बिकॉज इफ यू लुक एट देयर स्टोर एडिशन, FY22 वर्सेस FY23, दे एडेड 30 स्टोर्स. FY23 वर्सेस FY24, again they added 27 to 30 stores. Now in just one quarter, can you see, of Q4 of FY24 and Q1 of FY25, they've added 26 stores. So I hope you understand the kind of expansion these people are doing. Do saal mein 30 store dala sirf you know, in a period of a year. And this time in one quarter itself, they've added 26 stores. So June, ye investor presentation bana hai, taking the data of the months of April, May and June, as of June. But right now we are in September. So as of September, if you see, they have 181 stores. So if you look from the year end, from March to right now, I think they are down like 5 months. They've added how much? 140 to 181, almost 41 stores, which is more than the entire store that they added for the full year in FY24. Agar aap dekhte ho, quantity sold is nothing but aapka volume growth. Volume growth is also good at 20%. Now, if you look at over here, same store sales growth jo hai, it is here at 5%. Now, if you look at their same store sales growth for the full year of FY24, it was 9.4%. And they've maintained this 10 to 15% ka same store sales growth. I believe this 5% ka sales growth, the reason for this one, the reason for this 5% ka sales growth, I think the major part is because April, May and June, we saw that intense garmi tha na because of this heat wave and everything. And of course, the states like West Bengal, which is literally near the coastal area, they faced a lot of brunt over here. And on top of that, we had elections also, which probably would have hampered a lot of walk-ins, because these kind of stores, they do not have any online platform much. They are a brick and mortar store, right? So as a result, the walk-in must have affected very drastically because of these two reasons, right? That is why I think the same store sales growth has literally fallen, right? Other than that, if you see average transaction value, okay, it's almost in the same range. Volume growth is there, store count is increasing, same store sales growth is also okay, not that great. But having said that, I believe that is the reason why the SSG is at 5% and not at the higher double digit, you know, probably like a 10 to 15% for that reason itself. Now, this is as of Q1 FY25. I think by looking at the result, you can tell, although there is a good amount of sales growth, there is a good amount of things are going right for them, they're going in the proper direction, that they did a lot of interviews. So whatever they told in the interviews, they are actually doing way more than that, right? Because in the interviews, they told ki, like, you know, hum log jo 30% se hum grow kar rahe the, we will try to grow in that rate. We will open more stores. Bola tha 30 store kholega is saal mein, and already by 5 months they've opened around 41 stores, right? They told they will maintain a very good strong SSG of 10%, and also, you know, they'll maintain margins at 15% and more. As their private label will keep increasing, the chunk will keep increasing, they told unka margins bhi badhega. So they've done it, but I think the fact that elections tha, and on top of that itna garmi tha, has really hampered with the sales. And I think that is why 30% say these people were able to do 21%. And not just that, the fact that, you know, this incident has happened where their entire warehouse has caught fire. I think that has been, you know, really pulling them back, you know, in terms of at least showing a better numbers. Okay, so that is what, in terms of guidance, like I told you, they haven't really given a very specific numbers as to so, because these people did a lot of interviews in terms of I think after FY24 ka result, I mean FY24 ka year, which is after March, April na, that is when they started filing for IPOs, and Q1 FY25 ka result to nahi aaya tha. So during the interviews, they were talking based on the FY24 full year ka data. And like I told you, right, whatever they told as to so, they have done it. In the interviews, unhone bola tha ki, like, hum log private label ko 50% se leke jayenge by the end of FY25. But we are already in just one quarter, Q1 FY25. And in Q1 FY25 only, the private label ko contribution has gone to 51%. Similarly, they told they will add 30 stores in the full year. They've added 41 stores over here, right? And growth rate is also okay, I would say. And similarly, in terms of SSG also, quite fairly well, whatever they've told in terms of guidance. Now let us do, I think the last thing is we will talk about the valuation, and we will talk about the P2P. See, like I told you, right, in terms of valuation over here, the management hasn't given a very clear cut as to, like, you know, what is the kind of PAT margins they're trying to achieve, or what is the kind of PAT that they're looking for, right? That is something they haven't done. If you look at my previous videos, whenever we do a valuation, we do it based on the guidance that the management has given. Like if you talk about PGL, if you talk about V2 retail, they've always guided for a certain kind of numbers. So we were able to get a range of, you know, what the 1 year forward PE is like, and we were able to estimate as to, like, you know, is it a good bet or not. Now when you talk about a company like Style Bazaar, when there is no, like I told you, PAT margin ka koi guidance nahi, margins ka koi guidance nahi, ya PAT ka koi guidance nahi, and with that we have a very very bad incident that happened, right, a frivolous incident that happened where the warehouse is burning, it gets quite difficult to estimate ki, like, inka PAT kya hoga. Shayad jo FY24 se kiya usse bhi double hoga, that could also happen. Or maybe जो इनका जो Q1 में ये वेयरहाउस के साथ हुआ, इसके वजह से शायद लॉसेस विल कीप कंटिन्यूइंग, यू नो, टिल अ सर्टेन क्वार्टर, मे बी टिल द एंड ऑफ द ईयर, और शायद टिल Q3 या Q4, मे बी द कंपनी हैज टू फेस अ ब्रंट ऑफ दिस, यू नो, टेक इन द बॉटम लाइन. ओके, जस्ट अ सेकेंड गाइस. Okay, so now that is why I have taken, like, see, as you can tell, as of March 24, I think this is a bit self-explanatory slide only, but I'll still do it. March 24 mein PAT tha 22 crore, okay? And as of right now, today you see that the market cap is 2,665 crore, theek hai? Now I'm going to take the PAT growth over FY24. Let's say, इस साल में इन्होंने कोई भी पैट नहीं किया, बिकॉज वी ऑलरेडी सॉर इट Q1 में उनका ऑलरेडी लॉस था 50 लाख का. सो लेट्स से गोइंग फॉरवर्ड बाय द ईयर एंड FY25 में इनका पैट का ग्रोथ इज एब्सोल्युटली जीरो, कोई पैट का ग्रोथ नहीं बिकॉज ऑफ दिस वेयरहाउस का इंसिडेंट, एंड एज अ रिजल्ट इट विल बी 22 करोड़ ओनली. सिमिलरली लेट्स से 22 करोड़ में लेट्स से द पैट ग्रोज बाय 10% ओवर FY24 का बेस, और इट कैन डबल ऑल्सो. आई हैव टेकन वेरियस केसेस एंड द पैट कैन इवन डबल. लेट्स से आगे जाके शायद बाय द एंड ऑफ द ईयर वी कैन सी द पैट गो फ्रॉम 22 crore to 44 crore, you know, just like, because unka PAT on FY23 was 5 crore and in FY24 PAT was 22 crore. So it literally like went 4x, right? So hopefully if that happens, you can see here the whatever the market cap divided the by the expected PAT that you are expecting in FY25. This is the range of PE that we get. The PE can range from 60 to 121. I also believe that this company, when it got listed, they listed themselves in a bit of a higher valuation, because unka DRHP baby, they had written that, you know, they are competing against V2 Retail and V-Mart, and out of these both companies, they have the very strongest performance and leading performance for the last 2 years in terms of revenue and in terms of store count. But here is the thing, you can't compare yourself to V-Mart and V2 Retail. One thing was V-Mart is not able to grapple with whatever happened post-COVID, right? They had to cut down on their losses they had to cater to the demand, they had to cut down on the prices and everything. It was very tough. So you're literally comparing, it's like the winner of the class, the second boy or the first boy of the class is comparing, you know, jiska fail, jisne fail kiya. So it is not really a right comparison. The other thing is in terms of V2 Retail also, you can't call yourself, you know, 2 years ka comparison leke aap nahi bol sakte ki like hum V2 Retail se bhi very strong, because V2 Retail ka bhi wahi tha. They had acquired that Vishal Mart, because of which way they were loss making, then they had to let go of it, and then they had to completely change the entire operations from top to down. We saw that becoming from a, you know, from a loss to profit making engine. I think, you know, if you followed my videos, I've covered that company since the time it became a loss to profit. We've seen that, you know, they have consistently, I think for the last 3 quarters, have done a 50% का ग्रोथ इंजन था, 35% का सेम स्टोर सेल्स ग्रोथ था. सो नॉट रियली राइट कंपैरिजन. You are comparing both V-Mart when it is not performing well. You're comparing V2 Retail during the time it was a loss making engine, and you're calling yourself like, you know, hum log, we are the first boy of the class, and then you come up with this valuation, right? I think they try to match the valuation of V2 Retail, which it is currently at the market. But if you look at V2 Retail, the reason it has that valuation is because it went from a loss to profit and has been performing really well, right? So that is the only, I would say, probably if it got at least listed at a decent valuation, there would be a bit of scope. But I think it's just got listed at an extremely high valuation, leaving a very little, making it a very little room for, you know, for PE re-rating to go forward from here. Now talking about the P2P analysis, if you do, I have taken again three companies over here, Style Bazaar, comparing it with V2 Retail and V-Mart. I would say V-Mart is literally not the right comparison, because of course the company is not doing that great either in terms of like, it's getting better, but having said that, still not back to what it used to be glory days, at least before COVID, pre-COVID. Right now, if you look, can you see, this is all the data as of Q1 FY25. You will see that the revenue growth may also, you will see that V2 Retail is the highest with 57%. Style Bazaar is not, you know, literally V2 Retail is say like more than two times V2 Retail has done. Actually three times you can tell, right? Almost 3x, 2.8x V2 Retail has grown compared to Style Bazaar. Whereas V-Mart has hardly grown by 15%. Similarly with PAT growth, yaha pe can you see V2 Retail is enjoying a very good operating leverage compared to any of these two companies, right? V-Mart has gone from loss to profit this quarter. यहाँ पे इनको लॉस मिला है बिकॉज ऑफ उनका वेयरहाउस का इंसिडेंट. ओके, इवन इफ वो वेयरहाउस का इंसिडेंट नहीं होता, आई थिंक दे वुड हैव क्लॉक्ड व्हाट अराउंड 10 करोड़ which would be around, I think, 40% growth in PAT, still not in terms PAT growth. Agra percentage wise, take to year on year, still V2 retail would be beating Style Bazaar, even if it weren't for that incident. Similarly, Agra take to same store sales growth, can you look at it? V2 retail also operates in the same Hindi heartland, the belt, aapka West Bengal, Bihar, Odisha, Assam, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, they also operate in that same belt. In spite of that, can you see same store sales growth is around 37%, yahan pe 5%. यहाँ पे 11%. Similarly, in terms of number of stores, अगर आप देखते हो, here is the thing, this is as of Q1 FY25 का अगर आप presentation देखते हो, V2 retail had 127 stores, okay. Now, these people have 181 stores, this is as of today. Because इनका V2 retail का कोई update नहीं आया है, कि like, you know, after that, how many stores that they've opened or anything, no update has come. So that is why, I do not know if this would be the right metric to compare. Similarly, V-Mart, like I told you, V-Mart has been operational for a very long period of time. इसलिए इनका 448 स्टोर्स है. If you look here, let's talk about the one important thing. How many stores these people are going to add this year according to the management guidance? V2 Retail has told that we will add 50 to 60 stores. So if you look at V2 Retail, ये दो साल में अपना store double कर सकता है. So of course, इसका store expansion CAGR is higher compared to anybody else. V-Mart में अगर आप देखते हो, it is adding 7, it added 7 in Q1. So roughly you can tell 35 probably 35 to 40 they might add. I'm taking the higher end only. Let's say seven in a quarter. 7 4 are is 28. But I want to be a bit bullish because Q3 festival season and they'll add more, you know, and it could be around 35 to 40. Let's say V-Mart is adding. Even if that is a 40 stores, so it will literally take you almost literally 10 years to double the store count. So of course, right, there is no match. V2 Retail is doubling the store in 2 years. V-Mart is taking 10 years. Similarly, agar aap yahan pe dekhte ho, you will already see by a this in Z was, like I told you, management ne bola ke like 30 stores we will add in this pura saal, but in 5 months only they've added 41 stores. So going forward, if they add 60 stores, let's say in this year, I'm taking a rough estimate, let's say they will add 60 stores, then it will take them 3 years to double the store count. Or if they take, let's say if they are adding around 80 stores or something, then it will take 2 years. So store expansion rate almost in line with V2 retail. Okay. EBITDA margin also almost you can tell same hai sabka, 15.213. In fact, Style Bazaar ka zyada hai. Quite shocking here, I'll tell you, because Style Bazaar ka agar aap dekhte ho, their EBITDA margin is 15.2 just by having 52% in ka private label se. Whereas if you see V2 retail, 80% are private labels, okay? 80% matlab khud ka brand, jahan pe aap design kar rahe ho, manufacturing koi third party ko de rahe ho, and then after that you're selling in your store, aapka khud ka brand hai, you're not selling somebody's brand. 80% mein ka 13.4% EBITDA margin hai. So if they go from here, let's say I think they have a plan of taking it to 100% in a couple or 3 years, if they do so, we can see probably an increase in EBITDA margin over here. But I remember in the interview also, I think with CNBC, the management told ki like unka brand, if they're selling their own brand and if they're selling a third party brand, probably margins may shayad 1-2% ka hi difference hai. But in fact, even if that happens also, if you're seeing a little bit of margin improvement, you know, probably we can see much more operating leverage. Or maybe that is why we saw, you know, where is that? Can you see here? Yahan pe 25% se 31 hua, yahan pe 31 se 38 hua, right? Private label went from 31 to 38, hardly 7% increase. And although just increased by 7%, inka PAT jo hai, went from 5 to 22 crore in the last, from FY23 versus FY24. So I can only imagine if they go from 52% and if they keep increasing, the margins can increase. Because see, margins can increase. I think somebody had asked me the question as to like, how do you see the operating leverage come forth, right? And I think there was a question, I think somebody in my Mac post ka video asked like operating leverage and margins ka, you know, I think there was a confusion. So here margins can increase for quite a lot of reasons. One is because you do a change in product mix. You're selling a higher value product. Here the higher value product becomes your private label. You're increasing your distribution, so you're getting a lot of volume growth because of that. You're selling a lot of, you know, value growth products. So, you know, multiple reasons for this. This is few reasons I can think of in the B2C space why your margins can increase. And of course, right, if you're selling premium product and with that you're increasing your sales, of course, ultimately it will get reflected in your bottom line. Your margins will increase. If your margin is increasing, obviously, and if you keep your expenses in control, your operating leverage will be quite visible over here. So that is why I believe here, if they continue to do so, they can, you know, at least this can give, I believe this Style Bazaar can actually give a quiet tucker for V2 retail. Because if you look at the entire apparel space, AK Studio, which is like a bit in the premium or semi-premium also, if you're not premium, and in the value space, you're seeing V2 retail, right? There are only two companies that are performing really well. But the other thing is Studio ka thoda valuation expensive, but of course it justifies that valuation because of the performance. V2 retail is catching up with that Studio ka valuation because of its performance over the three quarters. I believe Style Bazaar can come and give a very good tucker, provided that the performance continues. Like, you know, they get back their jo unhone FY24 mein unka agar aap dekhte performance, I think the sales grew by 35%. So if they can get that kind of growth back, I think they can be a very, very good competitor for V2 retail. That is the only thing. That is why I think these two are much more apt over here. Even in terms of volume growth, dekho yahan pe 50% hai, yahan pe 20% hai. In all parameters, you can see here V2 retail is really winning over Style Bazaar, right? In terms of store expansion, growth, operating leverage bolo, volume growth bolo, everything you'll see V2 retail is winning against Style Bazaar. I believe one thing Style Bazaar did a little bit of, I think Hadbadiya bol sakte ho, your valuation, I don't know who did it, thoda sa list okay, it got listed at a very expensive valuation, because I think they saw V2 retail ka valuation right now that is there, and they wanted to match it up to that because they believe they operate in the same area. I think they somehow forgot to see ki like V2 retail literally went from a loss to profit making company and was clocking sales at 60%, 50%, 35% ka SSG hai for the last three quarters. I mean, when you come up with that kind of numbers, you also should do that. But when you are like a third boy of the class or like fourth boy, you can't expect to get the same treatment as a first boy of the class. That is the thing. So here also, in all the ways you can see, like I told you, V2 retail is winning. In terms of valuation also, I think it's not, like I told you, it's not right to compare V2 retail ka, let me just stop. It's not right to compare V2 retail ka valuation in terms of Style Bazaar because of the same reason, like I told you. V2 retail has justified the performance, you know, valuation, whatever it is, it has been justified by the performance. With Style Bazaar, it you got listed at like 100p only at start. And post that right now, everything is crumbling down with the warehouse and everything. But hopefully we get to see a turnaround in the story, because it is a good company, you can tell. 20% ka growth engine, at least minimum 20% ka growth engine hai. SSG, because this is a time, right? You're seeing a lot of apparel space. They're not performing well at all. Aap Reliance Trends ko dekho, I think the sales grew hardly by 8%. If you look at Shopper Stop, 5% sales growth, I think. If you look at this another company, I think it starts from C, Cantabile Retail. All of these companies not really performing well, not really up to the mark. And the fact that you're able to do in this space 20% to 21% growth is great. Hopefully going forward, we see that operating leverage is playing out over here. And jo bhi inka warehouses ka losses that is there is minimized. And probably we also see an increase in pace of sales growth, right? Because 21% at this valuation becomes a bit hard. But, you know, so hopefully we see ke like, you know, thoda sa pace of sales growth badh jaye and everything. And, you know, then it can justify the, probably it can justify the valuation it got listed in. So that's that about Style Bazaar, Bazaar Retail. Let's just see how it performs in Q2, because Q2 is just 20-30 days away. Let us see what is the impact of this warehouse and how has the SSG progressed and everything, right? I think it would be a much more better scenario to compare. So that's that about this company. I will see you again in another video next time. So take care. Until then, bye.